Caroline Herbert here from BBTV. I'm here with Connor, the Destroyer Ben. How are we doing?
Good, mate. You?
Yeah, good, good. Quick reaction to Joe Cordina's victory.
Smashed it out of the park, didn't he?
Yeah. And what do you think of how you're setting up that overhand right?
I wasn't surprised. Do you know what I mean? Wasn't surprised at all. He was. I said it can happen. Do you know what I mean? I know people weren't really. I don't know what the odds were for Joe to knock him out, but there we go. Got him out of there.
There was a lot of concern around ringside just after the first round because everyone was saying Ogawa looked really good. Were you concerned at all?
Yeah, but Joe looked really good. Ogawa looked good, but so did Joe. Do you know what I mean? So that's where that ends. You look good, but they're going to look good at this level.
And what did you expect before the fight, and how did it play out in terms of how
I'm
you thought it was going?
As in, I know Joe can deliver like that. It's the element of surprise, and it's the shot you don't see coming. So I said that in numerous interviews. But for it to actually happen, it was I was just really happy for him.
Yeah.
Because his legacy, his life changed forever. Do you know what I mean? In a split second of a punch, history's made. Third Cardiff World Champion, 13th World Champion. That's it done. That's cemented in legacy.
Not just his life, he's changing lives of boxers around Wales as well.
Well, he's changed it. First off, he's changed his family's life. He will now change the lives of fighters in Wales and, give inspiration to the younger fighters in Wales. Joe knows where he comes from, everyone knows where he comes from. So for Joe to do that and do it in the style that he's done it, it's nothing short of a blessing and all the years of hard work that he's put in the game of sport boxing. So, it's inspiring and motivating the fights in the matchroom gym as well. And that's what it's about, isn't it?
Yeah, you're sticking around to watch the football tomorrow?
I've got a wife and baby at home.
You don't want to watch Gareth Bale do a business?
Listen, I have fun asking my wife if I can fucking stay for the football. She should tell you what's happening tomorrow.
Cheers, Connor.